into the language of Isaiah 14 and 1, you can clearly see that it's talking about Israelite strangers, alright? Because they actually Jacob, alright? But they are scattered in the different places, alright, in the different countries today. But, you know, all around the earth, alright, to the four corners, four directions, alright. In the four ends of the earth, alright, in the four ends of the earth. And for the Lord will have mercy on Jacob, alright. So, only on Jacob, alright. And will yet choose Israel and set them in their own land, alright. And the strangers, so that's talking about the Israelites, alright. That's talking about the Israelites. Because even when they sometimes look like the other nations in their nations, which, you know, which they were scattered, alright, they are still Israelites, alright, because their seed line, their father's side goes back to Jacob, alright, that's the first person who we have read, you see. Let's go on. So that's actually precept upon precept, alright, in one verse, alright, and set, and set them in their own land, alright. And the strangers shall be joined with them, alright? And they shall cleave to the house of Jacob, alright? Because they are Jacob, alright? That's why they join unto Jacob. It's not like, you know, they are not Jacob, and, you know, they join unto Jacob, and, you know, they are two different, you know, two different parts or something, alright? That's not who, alright? Let's go on. Isaiah 14 and 2. And the people shall take them and bring them to their place. So that's talking actually about the heathens, alright? The other nations, alright? Let's say you have, if you watched my last video, alright? You have, some of them are Israelites of the Japanese, alright? But the other part is Ammonites, alright? That's their heritage according to the Bible, alright? And if you go to prophecy, that's not a good heritage in this time, alright? You know, but the other part are Israelites there, alright? And guess what? It's not talking about them here, alright? It's talking about the actually heathens, the Ammonites in Japan, alright? For example, right? Japan is only an example, alright? But you have many Israelites over there, alright? And let's see. And the house of Israel, so that's again talking about us, alright? The real Israelites, alright? What we have read in the first verse. Shall possess them, alright? So the heathens, alright? That's even in Psalms, alright? Ask for me and I will give thee the heathens for thy possession, alright? That's nothing new, alright? You can look that up. Right. In the land of the Lord, of Yahweh, you see. So when we back in our land, all right. Because at the moment, the fake Jews dwelling over there, all right. They are called also bastard according to the Bible, all right. For servants and handmaids. So all right, there will be servants and handmaids, all right. And they shall take them captives, whose captives they were. And that's also precept upon precept. It's, I think it's Isaiah. Alright, it's talking about, he that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. Alright. So lucky from English. I, you know, sometimes I mix up some German in it. Alright. And that's actually precept upon precept, because it's talking about the same thing here, alright? It's talking about one and the same thing here, alright? Captives, alright? whose captives they were, alright? We were captives in America, right? In the first place, but also, you know, in the whole world, alright? Because Israelites, you know, pretty much hated. Because what? Because they received no blessing, alright? They received their lifetime in this world, alright? Their, you know, their inheritance, alright? And guess what? Everybody wants the blessing that we got, that Jacob got, but, you know, they will never have it, alright? So that's why they hate you, alright? Because this lifetime, or this world time, alright, Esau Edom's wicked rulership, alright, is almost over, okay? And he knows it. Of course, you have to keep the laws, alright, as best as you can till it's over, alright, till you no longer can do it, alright. But, you know, it's almost over. And there will be a time when, you know, the actions will stand in their own power and that stuff, you know. And they shall rule over their oppressors, right? So who are the oppressors? The oppressors always the heathens, all right? All the heathens are oppressors, all right? Because they, you know, make gatherings, you know, how they can oppress Israel for, you know, longer, all right? Because it's almost over, all right? And you know that's just what they're doing, all right? Because they received not the blessing what we received, all right? So, you know, it's just what it is, all right? So there you can see that it's actually talking about the real Israelites that will join onto the house of Jacob, what are also Israelites, and there you go, all right? Nothing else, nothing more, alright? And if you go into the language, you will of course not get anything else out of it, alright? Nothing, alright? Let's see. Alright, here you see of Jacob, Yaakov, alright? Yaakov. For the Lord, alright, here is, you know, it's written Jehovah, but we of course know that it's Yahweh, alright? Even when the manuscripts, alright, with the name, alright? Yahweh is the real name because it's from the real language, alright? From the Lashon Kodash, alright? That's why it's the real name, you see? On Jacob, Yaakov, alright? Bachar, alright? That has to do with Jews. Alright, Bakar, Yisrael, alright. So, not all Israel is Israel, according to Romans, Book of Romans. So, you know, you always have to go precept upon precept, alright. Especially to snare the heathen, because they have no understanding, alright. And then you go on Adama, I think it means like land, alright. There you go with the name Adam, alright, because he is taken from the earth, alright. So the wood is maybe earth or something, I don't know. Alright, Adama, them in their own land, alright. And the strangers, alright, let's go into this word here. Shall be joined with them. Strangers. One is actually a sojourner, A is a temporary inhabitant, a newcomer lacking inherited rights, you see, of foreign, alright. Salakia for my English. I hate English, man, alright? It's Babylonian, especially this Babylonian English today, alright? In Israel, tough conceited whites, alright. So this talking about Israelite foreigners, alright. That's what I already told you. So the Blue Letter Bible, don't goes off on this point, alright. It's true, alright. Even the Masoretic text, alright, the best text what you can Salakia, it's the Textus Receptus, alright, the Greek Salakia, alright, because it's actually no, Masoretic, alright, Masoretic Salakia. We are in the so-called Old Testament, alright. This is a prophet, alright. Because it's our Greek, it's the Septuagint, all right. We don't want that, all right. You want in the so-called Old Testament, you want the Masoretic text, and in the so-called New Testament, you want the Textus Receptus, all right. That's what you want because, they have the unchanged words still over there, mostly, all right. So strangers are actually no strangers, alright, according to the real understanding of the Bible, alright. Laid out by the prophets and by the people of the Bible, alright. Shall be joined, lover, with them, and they shall cleave. To join, attach to, join together, you see? So it is not talking about, some kind of different spirits, alright, or something, different parts. Nah, alright, this is talking about the 12 tribes, alright? This is talking about the 12 tribes, and the 12 tribes are all in the same spirit, alright? The same spirit because they are Israelites, so you will inherit the spirit of your father, alright? So that's why we have this, look like heathens, but actually they are Israelites, alright? And you can discern them ultimately by your spirit, alright? Test the spirit, alright? Let's get that quick, alright? Just quick, Don't want to. To make it too long, all right. So it's already proven, all right. This is talking about Israelite foreigners, all right, not about some heathens or what, all right. First John, and this is actually the so-called New Testament, all right. First John 4:1. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits, whether they are of Yahweh, because many false prophets are going out in the world, alright? Example, what's his name? IYC, alright? He calls himself Christ, alright? Priest, And he pretty much said that you can take the vaccines, alright? And Jacob's trouble is not there, all right? That's also what I found out, all right? So you get beamed up, he said, or the group said, all right, and they have to have it from him, all right, because he's the leader, all right, obviously. So there is no Jacob's trouble, all right? Because Israel will get beamed up, all right, in Jacob's trouble, you see? But at the same time, there is some of ID chip and temptation, all right, that makes no sense to me, all right. And they all found out that we are right about the of ID chip, all right. Of course, GMS Great Millstone, of course, you will see that, until the end is here, all right, until Yahweh Shai pops up out of heaven, all right. Then you see the whole truth of GMS Great Millstone, all right. I don't know, man. I don't want to bear false witness, all right, but IYC pretty much said that you not here in Jacob's trouble, all right. It's the same thing what the Christians would tell you, all right. confused Christians that there is some kind of, what is it? We meet us in the heavens, alright? You know, just some gathered out of nothing, alright, with no understanding out of the Bible, alright? Because every, you know, I can give everybody the Bible and they can read something out of it, alright? That's not the point. I leave it with that, alright? So, you know, in the second Exodus, alright, there is no heathens, alright, no heathen women, alright, no heathen men, alright, nothing like that, alright? But what? But what, alright? Let's get it. Strangers shall build your kingdom. I don't know if it's, you know, if the all the words are in there, alright, but you see, it's easy to find it. Isaiah 16 and 10. And the sons of strangers shall build up thy walls, alright? And this is still the same prophet, I think, alright? But in whole other chapter, alright, I think it's also Isaiah here. Yes, it's Isaiah, alright? So, this is chapter 60, alright? Precept upon precept, man. You see? Precept upon precept. Alright? That's what Israelites do, alright? Shall build up thy walls, alright? And their kings shall minister unto thee. For in my wrath I smote thee, but in my favor I have had mercy on thee, alright? So, the Most High only has mercy on Jacob, alright? See? And you have some brothers from Germany, alright? There's an arc that, you know, he uploaded a video about whom Yahweh will have mercy, you know, in these times, see? And, you know, I put the link in the description, you see? That's the spirit, man, alright? Because we from GMS, we will tell you that to warn you and to, you know, to make you prepare for these things, for these times, see? Alright? Therefore thy gates shall be open continually. They shall not be shut day or, nor night, alright? So, you know, the kingdom, you know, it will have, you know, night and day, alright? You know, before I came into this truth, you know, I was in the belief that there is no night, alright? But it's actually written that there is no sun needed, alright? That does not have to mean that there is no moon and no night and no day, Salakim, alright? Just interesting, man, alright? From GMS, another arc said that there will be maybe night and day, alright? If that's the correct way he said it, alright? Of course there is no sun needed, because what, alright? If you have Yahweh, alright, here in his, not in his full presence, alright, because he is pretty much everything, alright? But if you have his spirit here, alright, that deep, alright, it will be pretty much not... you know, the earth will be not needed, will be not in need of a sun, alright? You can't have him here, alright, because he is actually too bright, alright, for something like that, alright? That man may bring unto thee the forces of the Gentiles, you see? The forces of the Gentiles, the, you know, whatever they have, alright? And their kings may be brought. Alright? For the nation and kingdom that will not serve thee shall perish, alright? And I told you that the full control, the full might, alright? The full might, if it's the right English word, right? It would be it in German, alright? The Israelites will have, and just take it with the word, alright? The full might, alright, of the heathen, alright, So you can pretty much do what you want, alright? Here, those nations shall be utterly wasted, you see? Of course, we have the Torah, alright? We're not unrighteous like Esau, Edom, alright? But, you know, we rule according to the Torah, alright? And, you know, every heathen will know that there are actually Israelites out there, and, you know, they're pretty much there to make you live again in the kingdom, alright? Because, you know, that's what we have today is not really living, alright? Because everything is defiled by Esau, right? The woman, the planet, themselves, alright? That's why they don't believe that, alright? See? So, everybody has to see it, alright? Until that point comes, you alright? Even of our own people, the Israelites, alright? They won't believe it, you see? So that's why everything has to be made new, alright? And then you will see that actually there are more, gold, silver, whatever, alright? Diamonds. You will see that, alright? First time in your whole spiritual being, alright? When the Israelites are in rulership, alright? It don't belongs to you, alright? Because you are not an Israelite, alright? Just an example. But you will see that, alright? And you will kinda like that, alright? Even when, when you have to give your possessions onto us, you know? Let's say that, for example, but, you know, it's just the Torah, and the Torah makes laws, alright? And we rule according to the law, alright? But the Gentiles will bring their treasures, their, the forces, you know? They're a pretty woman, alright? You know, they're virgins. Whatever, man, alright? I don't have to tell you that, alright? You will see it, and, you know, it's just a blessing for the Israelites. So just imagine, alright, these wicked elites, alright? Even whole Esau Edom, the nation of whole Esau Edom, wants to have this blessing. And, you know, when they have this whole world right now, alright? Guess what? This blessing has to be something really great, alright? You see? And it's the birthright, alright? And it also, you know, will be according to that, alright? So you can't compare anything on this world, alright? Even if you have somebody, let's say, he has, you know, a place, a whole island, alright? And he has gold, silver on this island, alright? He has, like, you know, 1,000 women, whatever, man, alright? You can't compare anything, alright, to the kingdom of the Israelites, alright? And it's even, it's even not directly, alright, for the heathens, alright, to see or to go inside, alright? We can read that nobody can go inside, alright? So the heathens will not see everything, alright, but they will see from far off, alright, that is, you know, that is actually Salah, you know, some greatness, alright, that is not from this earth, alright, because Yahweh can do pretty much everything, alright, he can bring the poorest gold, the poorest diamond planet, alright, he can break pieces out of it, alright, and bring it to the earth, alright? And even we can do that maybe, alright? Still in the 1,000 year kingdom, alright? So, you know, nobody saw that, alright? That's a verse what you can read, alright? No eyes, Salachia, no eyes have seen. Right, this has to be something really great, man. Right, even when the heathens know that they will be in slavery, especially Esau Edom, right, they never saw something like this. Right, no ears heard. Right, think it is this combination. Right, just put KJV behind it, and it always, you know, comes out something. Right. So this is 1 Corinthians 2:9, but as it is written, I had not seen, nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man, the things which God had prepared for them that love him. Alright? See? So, you can't even imagine, alright? Just, you know? Compare that to all your positive, alright, dreams that you had, alright? And it's nothing, alright? Nothing. Alright? And I know that, you know, from myself, you know, that I had this dreams, alright, and it's nothing, man, it's nothing, alright. I know that, for sure, alright. But he gives you a little spiritual insight of things that are possible, alright. Let's say you can, you know, all that stuff, alright. Just imagine, alright. Yeah, and that's pretty much it, alright. You brought that precept out, alright. And the point is made, alright. There are no strangers, alright. And all the strangers that are referred to from the Bible are Israelite foreigners, alright. So they are actually Israelites, you see. And that's also the point in Revelation about the people from all nations with palms in their hand, alright? They are all Israelite foreigners, alright? And their father's seed line, again, goes back to our forefather, Jacob, alright? Yaikrab, alright? And with that, shalom to the elect, all praises to the Most High. Yehovah Hashem, Yehovah Shai, alright? Keep praying, keep fasting, and see you in the next video, alright? Kalalayam, Yehovah Hashem, Yehovah Shai, Havaka Kodash. Shalom.